I'll try to answer your questions so that you can internalize and internalize the whole completion process and understand and live the whole completion process. Questions.
The first question today is from Inner Awakening participant Dr. Pranjal, ID number 57. She's asking, if enriching happens by an incomplete person, it doesn't really reach people. It might help the enricher, but the other person might be going away instead of coming. Shouldn't the enricher completely be complete before enriching?
Completely completing will happen ultimately only with enlightenment. So Dr. Pranjal, understand, completion, enriching, both are not supposed to be done one after the another. Both are supposed to be done simultaneously. Please understand. In Patanjali's yoga, there is a word called Ashtanga Yoga. 8 parts. Somehow, unfortunately, all the English yogis have translated this as 8 steps of yoga. That one small mistake, the Anga word, Ashta means 8, that there is no controversy. This Anga, instead of translating that word as parts, it has been translated, not even the word, even word parts is too superficial. Anga word should be translated as organs. Because they have not translated this Anga as organ, instead of organ, they translated that as a step. The whole yoga tradition has become useless in the West. It has become just a small few techniques are the methods to make your body flexible and little health. That's a disgrace done to yoga. Please understand. When you get a diamond and use the diamond just as a vegetable cutter, it's a disgrace to diamond. Same way, when you use such great power, powerful science, just as technique to bring little health. No. It is so unfortunate. Just that one mistake done by the Max Mullerians, means followers of Max Muller, trying to translate Hindu scriptures just to destroy Hinduism, not for making the world realize the greatness of Hinduism. The Max Mullerians, in my sampradaya, in Nityananda sampradaya, nowhere the Max Muller or Max Mullerian's translations should be accepted as a reference textbook. I'm banning Max Muller and Max Mullerian's translations of Hindu scriptures. They have done the translation more to abuse the Hinduism, not to make people understand Hinduism. This Max Mullerian translation of the word Ashtanga, instead of 8 organs of yoga, it has been translated 8 steps of yoga over. And people are struggling with the second step and third step. Yama, Niyama, Yoga, Asana, over. No one crosses beyond yama, and yama is integrity, niyama is authenticity. Please listen. Asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana is responsibility, dhyana and samadhi is enriching. Please listen. You are asking, should we do it one after the another? No. No, understand. This is also like Ashtanga. 8 organs, not 8 steps. Enriching and completion, both are simultaneously, both should be practiced. Listen. With more and more completion, more and more enriching will happen. With more and more enriching, completion will happen. Actually, when you complete with somebody, you already started enriching that person. How many of you have realized? I think still this batch has not yet started completing with others. But whoever has started completion with others, the moment you complete with others, you already started enriching the other person. Enriching starts happening. With the completion. Without enriching, completion cannot happen. Without completion, enriching cannot happen. It is like you start both together. One supports the other. You cannot say, first I'll operate my heart, and then once the heart starts functioning completely, then I'll start operating the lungs. No. Lungs is completion. Heart is enriching. Both has to happen simultaneously. Lungs remove the carbon dioxide incompletions from your system, infuses oxygen completion into your system. Heart circulates that whole oxygen through the blood and enriches your whole body. You cannot separate enriching and completion. If you are not enriching, be very clear, your completion is not happening. You are only fantasizing about completion. Completion is so powerful. When you really get into it, you will simply enrich. I tell you, I have no other motive other than enriching to come and sit day in and day out to speak to people even though they don't listen to me. There is no other motive. Completion. Completion is so powerful, it just makes you enriching. I tell you, the intelligence of enriching. Actually, you don't even need to be taught to enrich. There is no need for somebody to teach you how to do. Maybe they can give you tips to do enriching in a better way. But when you start completion, you will simply start enriching because so much of energy intelligence, inspiration, love will be available to you. That is what yesterday after the process, I could see the whole group feels beautiful love. Please understand, making one person feel loving and loved with a group is not a joke. It is not a joke. Yesterday I could see, after the whole program, after the session of especially looking at you as your mamakar, inner image, outer image and life image, and introducing yourself to others with your inner image, outer image and life image, I tell you, the first thing will happen to your being is love. Love. So much of love. There is no need for others to come and tell you to enrich. You will see the enriching happens by its very nature. Please understand, when you complete, your thinking will start becoming more aware. See, when the awareness enters into your thinking, you will just know life has no pleasure other than enriching. Please understand, this is the essence. It is the unaware thinking which makes you believe life has some pleasures. The moment awareness enters into your thinking, the moment your thinking is filled with awareness, you will understand life has no pleasure. Life has no pleasure other than enriching. How much ever you try, how much ever you try, it is complete lie . It's false statement, superstition, to believe life has pleasures. Whoever has that spread that superstition, he should be arrested under superstitious law. He should be arrested under the anti-superstition bill. How much ever you may try to believe, you even believe as a collective belief, mass hysteria. All the crowd in the MG Road, Bangalore, is nothing but mass hysteria. All the crowd which is searching here, there, thinking that life has pleasure, is hypnotized. In the mass hysteria, your thinking will become straight with completion. And I tell you, when awareness enters into your thinking, when you start thinking with awareness, you will realize life has no pleasures. Listen. How many of you in your heart really believe life has no pleasures? Raise the hand. You guys have started thinking with awareness. Really, I'm telling you. If you think life has pleasures, you just need to bring little awareness into your thinking, nothing else. Whatever you call as pleasure, when it happens to you, just see how you feel about you, how your inner space feels. In few days you will understand life has no pleasures. So the only thing pleasant in the life is enriching. I'm really telling you, the only thing pleasant in the life is enriching. Life has no pleasure. Life has no pleasures other than enriching. Listen, I have a story about bringing awareness into your thinking. A man walks into a shop and sees a cute little dog like Bhairav. He asks the shopkeeper, "Does your dog bite?" The shopkeeper says, "No, my dog does not bite." The man tries to pet the dog and the dog nicely bites him. Ouch! The man screams, shouts. He says, "I thought you said your dog doesn't bite." The shopkeeper replies, "Yes, my dog doesn't bite, but that is not my dog." Bring awareness into your thinking. Don't take the gap, the missing links for granted. Your idea, life as pleasures, is nothing but taking the missing links for granted. Don't take missing links for granted. Connect all the missing links by a proper word. Only then you will understand, yes, his dog doesn't bite, but this dog is not his dog. The moment he said, "My dog doesn't bite," the second statement you took it for granted, that this dog is not his dog, this dog is his dog. In life also, please understand, many times after running behind certain goals, ideas for 30, 40 years, you realize the missing links you took it for granted. That is the such waste of life and time and energy. Blessed are those who entered Gurukul life when they are young. Blessed are those who at least entered the life with the master when they are young. Really, life as pleasures is the greatest delusion with which you are living. And you say, no, that is the way my mother-in-law told me, my father-in-law told me, my brother told me, my sister told me. When life stares at you, you cannot hide behind anybody's pallu. Know that very clearly. Pallu is the sari cloth, end of the sari. Forget about anybody's pallu. When life is chasing you, you cannot hide behind any person. So don't live because he said life is like that, she said life is like that. They said life is like that. Doubting pattern of. Please listen. The doubting pattern you carry about you makes you believe everyone else other than the truth. Because you don't trust you, you have self-doubt, you believe your mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, father-in-law, all in-laws, and you outlaw life. You tell about this person, that person, my mother told, father told, brother told, husband told. No. Understand. Life as pleasures is the greatest superstition spread in the modern world by the materialistic civilization and materialistic media. It is a superstition spread by materialistic mainstream media. What is the statement these guys are trying to give when they pose with some denim jeans, iPad, iPhone, all these models? They try to give you, they try to promise, with this life will be with a lot of pleasure, cool, which is not, fool. It is superstition spread by the so-called mainstream media. The superstition they are spreading. I saw a joke in the Facebook. A daughter is sitting with iPhone. She says, iPhone. Wife is sitting, iPad. Son is sitting with iPod. Husband is sitting with head on his hand, I paid. It's so unfortunate. Please be very clear. Life has no pleasure other than enriching. So, if you are being driven by any force, imagination, visualization, fantasy, thinking, thought, idea, other than enriching, be very clear. You are going to end up in depression. So do not encourage, enrich, entertain. The idea, life has some pleasures other than enriching. Drop it. Life has no pleasures other than enriching. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.